is everything is easier when you're riding a secular trend. Why was my career successful? I rode two trends. One was the rise of the derivative market. Gigantic. It's a $1.4 quadrillion market now. That was one. The other was the rise of hedge funds. So I had the biggest customer base and the biggest product.
During this most recent interview regarding the timing of shifts, he emphasizes the importance of capturing this mega trend, advising investors to focus on major tokens and avoid excessive risk at the time of this discussion. Raoul Pal, co-founder and CEO of Real Vision, shares his bullish perspective on the growth potential of the cryptocurrency market. Pal envisions the crypto asset class growing from $2.5 trillion to an astounding $100 trillion. He describes it as the largest, fastest accumulation of wealth in the history of the entire human race, a decline of 1% in the last 24 hours, and a decrease of 2% in the last 7 days has brought the price of Bitcoin down to approximately $63,000. The current value of cryptocurrency is approximately $2.5 trillion. When compared to traditional markets such as equities and derivatives, Pal believes that it has huge potential for growth. Before we delve further into Pal's thoughts, make sure to like, subscribe, and share this channel. Now let's explore more of Raoul Pal's crypto vision.
Okay, so that means I can't be 3x levered. Can a 50% drawdown happen? Yeah, you might get one of those in a bull market. So I can't be 2x levered. So I can't take leverage. I just can't unless you're really short-term trading. But that's not the game. So I can't do it. And then I start thinking, well, do you just buy the deep in the money call options on Deribit and use those? Because then you can't lose more than you buy in premium. But in the end, I just stop myself and just say, just don't fuck this up. Just don't fuck it up.
That's it.
Right. I just don't want to fuck this up because it matters to me. I've got a lot of money, wealth, ego, everything riding on this thing like we all have.
Yeah.
Just don't want to fuck it up.
The simpler, the more boring, the better.
Because again, if you think about the 5% yield or the 10% yield people are fighting for, oh, I'm going to do this and swap to that, and then I've got this bridge and I'm getting 12% yield over there. I'm like, Solana moves 12% in a day. How's this compensating you for risk taking? It's just not worth it. You don't need to. I don't do any of that. No farming for points or drops or anything.
But you stake your soul.
Nope.
Don't stake. Okay.
I don't even stake.
Okay.
Now, it's probably stupid, but I'm like, I don't need the 5%. I just put it in my ledger. Or I, you know, store it in a multi-sig. And I don't need to worry about it.
Yeah.
That's why I got into this in the first place. Was realizing that you didn't own your assets in a financial system. I'm not going to make the same mistake and give somebody my assets or give somebody control of my assets or give somebody a share of my assets. The beauty of crypto is self-custody. It's so magical. And people don't yet understand that. They will. Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. And just never lose control of your crypto because number go up. Right. And the whole game is to throw you off that one magic thing. It's just hold or hodl. You know, that thing is real. This is a really important point. Is everything is easier when you're riding a secular trend. Why was my career successful? I rode two trends. One was the rise of the derivative market. Gigantic. It's a $1.4 quadrillion market now. That was one. The other was the rise of hedge funds. So the biggest customer base and the biggest product. You can't help but make money. That's a secular trend. You want to be in places with a secular... You want to live in a country where the economy is growing on a secular basis. It's like one of the reasons why Spain is difficult to live in. Most of Europe is like a museum now. It's beautiful, but it's not a place to be an entrepreneur because the economy's not growing. Same with Japan. And China's gone kind of ex-growth. India's the fastest growing economy, the Middle East. But there's two trends that are easily investable that are in a secular trend. Every day, and it's all the same trend, every day is more digital than the previous day. It's as simple as that. And therefore, this whole trend of digitalization of everything, including human intellect, including human labor, that's robots and AI, including money, everything, is going to outperform. So just ride that trend and don't overthink it. I see so many people wanting to trade commodities here and this cycle there, and I'm like, you're wasting your time. You don't need to do all of that stuff. I've been guilty of all of that stuff, but I've realized that you don't need to do any of it.
Based on what we were told, as Raoul Pal provides insights on the current financial landscape and the challenges that younger generations are facing, he emphasizes the importance of identifying and investing in long-term transformative trends. He also highlights the fact that digitization is a key secular trend, stating that every day is more digital than the day before. This trend encompasses a variety of sectors, including finance, culture, and technology. He draws parallels between the current state of cryptocurrency and the early days of the internet, suggesting that we are on the edge of transformative technology. Pal recommends investors to concentrate their attention on areas that are experiencing steady growth, such as the cryptocurrency and digital asset space. It is recommended by Innovations Pal to think about the long term and to avoid becoming distracted by the short-term volatility in the market. Let's get back to the topic at hand and gather additional information from R. Pal about the ways in which these long-term trends are influencing the future of technology and finance.
Because all assets are correlated to this, the business cycle and the everything code cycle. It's all a debt refi cycle. So if everything is correlated, then diversification doesn't work. Mm. So if diversification doesn't work, then you want to own the asset with the best risk-adjusted returns. Now, this is where people get weird. They're like, yeah, but crypto goes down 80% every 4 years. On a risk-adjusted basis, it is an alien asset class. The reward so far outweighs the risk that people can't get their heads around an asset that goes down 98% like Solana and still compounds at 250% a year. So when I take a chart of everything, I just compare one asset to another. And I look at the chart of NASDAQ. Looks amazing. It's a log, secular, exponential trend, divided by the price of Bitcoin to see relatively how it's done. It's down 97.9%.
I think it's 99.92.
That's right. I mean, that's like, okay, so
there's no second best.
There is no second best. Making another investment decision is suboptimal if you've got the right time horizon. Mm. You know, it doesn't work if you choose. If you choose too short a time horizon, but choose a five-year, 10-year time horizon, it's ludicrous the difference that you kick yourself. If you went, oh, I had choice of the orange pill or the blue pill, and I took the blue pill and it's gone up, but I've made 99% less than I would have if I'd taken the orange pill.
Yeah. And
we've never seen anything like this before. So this is super unusual. People can't get their heads around this. People go into the space, fuck it up, go, whoa, this is too crazy for me. Mm. They then absorb a bit. They come with a bit of humility. They come back to the space, and slowly it becomes everything. I've seen all my macro friends do this. I've watched them all. My peer group, the people I grew up with in the industry, one by one, just go to the black hole and jump into the abyss and never come back. People like Alan Howard, legend of our space. We launched hedge funds at the same time. Alan was always a better trader than me and was famous as one of the greatest traders around. I mean, he's all crypto. Dan Tapiero, Dan Moorhead. Mm. Just one after the other, they get there. and then never come back because the returns on a risk-adjusted basis are so ridiculous that they realize this is the, if there's one trade to dedicate your life to, this is the trade. This is the big one.
Raoul Pal continues to be optimistic about the potential for the cryptocurrency market to grow from 2.5 trillion to 100 trillion, describing it as the largest, fastest accumulation of wealth in the history of humanity. Pal emphasizes the importance of capturing this mega trend while avoiding excessive risk. We would love to hear your thoughts on this matter. When it comes to the possibility for the cryptocurrency industry to reach 100 trillion, do you agree with Pal's assessment? In what ways do you intend to navigate the cryptocurrency industry in a secure manner while yet making the most of possible gains? We believe that in the crypto blockchain and Web3 space, our collective goal is to increase attention and drive adoption by sharing valuable insights and educational content. We aim to contribute to the growth and understanding of this innovative industry. If you enjoyed this discussion, please subscribe, like, and share our video for more engaging content diving into the innovative world of decentralized technologies.